Welcome to your weekly UAS news update. This is week 61. This week I got four topics I want to talk about. The first one is a company called AiRXOS. I know the name is hard to pronounce, quite frankly. They have a new solution for energy companies, and then we'll talk about that solution. I want to show you one of the coolest drones that I have seen in a very long time. It comes from Flying Picture, which is a company in the UK. And then I want to talk about a gentleman that was arrested. This was a while back. I've been wanting to talk about this for a while, so you'll get some more information. He was arrested for flying over somebody's property, and there's a lot of just bad stuff going on with this. And then lastly, I want to give you a little bit of an update on Pilot Institute. So let's get going. And the first thing this week is I want to talk about this company, AiRXOS, which doesn't roll off the tongue very easily. AiRXOS, they're a UTM company, Unmanned Traffic Management company. And they released a new package solution for energy companies. So any energy company out there that uses drone for inspections and a lot of different things. The platform offers a cool ecosystem that's going to do a whole lot of different things. It's going to do planning, it's going to do scheduling, it's going to do operational and monitoring things for all the drones. And it's based on their platform called Air Mobility Platform. And it's all class-based, cloud-based. It's all integrated into one application, essentially. So if you want more information in this, if you're actually in this industry, in this business, this might be something that may be of interest to your company. This is not necessarily going to be something for the individual person. This is a little bit more large scale, if you want. The next thing is something really neat. I kind of want to call this drone porn, but in a good sense. This is a flying machine. This is a new drone from Flying Picture, which is a company based in the UK. And they released this drone, and they call it the world's most powerful drone for cinematography. And it kind of piqued my interest because, well, world's first, world's best, world's everything, right? But I kind of have to agree, this thing is pretty badass. 243 pounds maximum takeoff weight. So this is not your sub-55-pound drone. This is a big machine. Maximum payload of 132 pounds, and then a maximum speed of 56 knots. If you think about 56 knots with this kind of weight, this is a large machine. You can see the footage going on in the background, and I hope they don't mind that we're showing you this, but this really made my evening as I was watching the video. I watched it twice just because the equipment in there. I love photography, videography, and this kind of equipment just gets me going. I just look at this, and again, I watched it several times. Quadcopter, so it's got four different arms, but dual motors on each of the legs, which is, again, for additional power. And you can put the payload at the top or actually at the bottom, depending on the type of camera you have on there. They have some really cool, neat cameras on this thing. So not, again, probably for the layman like you and I. It's going to be more for large production companies. And for themselves, this is what they do. They're an aerial company provider. They do this on a helicopter. They do it with drones. So just kind of bridging the gap between the two. When you see the size of the cameras on there, there's no real reason to be flying a helicopter anymore, I would think. The next thing, a little bit more serious, this happened 2 years ago, but it's been in the news quite a bit. And I've been meaning to talk about this because I've been talking about this with my friend Sarah Nielsen, who's a UAS attorney, and we kind of went back and forth. And this is just a bad situation that can set a really bad precedent. So we have to kind of follow what is going on as an industry, as a community. James Benson lives in Louisiana, and 2 years ago he was flying in his neighborhood and ended up flying over his neighbor's property. So far, so good, right? You are allowed to do this. You can fly over your neighbor's property. Flew at around 400 feet. Neighbor complained. He gets arrested. And not only that, but he goes in front of a judge. The trial goes for 3 days. The judge looks at the evidence. He wants to share his data because he wants to use it to say, hey, I'm just flying around. There's two flights apparently that get in front of the judge, two of the flight data. And the judge says, well, the camera was pointing down, so you were conducting surveillance, so you need to be arrested for what you did. And so What comes out of this is there's an expert, supposedly expert, that testifies in court and says that from 400 feet with a consumer drone, you can actually, they say, and I haven't read the full report, but from what I read from the news report, that you can see from 400 feet the details on a smartphone, which is, as you may know, total BS. And so he gets sentenced to 2 years probation, can't own a drone for 2 years. And all of the reason behind all this is that he was charged for trespassing because he was conducting surveillance. If you conduct surveillance, then they're allowed to charge you with trespassing. This is big. This is big because this is kind of a first. And if this continues to go, he's going to take this to the Louisiana Supreme Court. And if he loses, then we all as a community tend to lose a lot in this case, because now you have local governments that can actually go after a person for doing something that's entirely legal, in this case, just flying your drone around your neighborhood. So what is next? It's kind of a question mark at this point. He's not really talking much because he's in the middle of this trial. And of course, he can't really give any details at this stage. So I'm going to keep following this just like a lot of other people are. And I'll give you more information when that comes out. He has a GoFundMe page, which is overfunded at this stage, but I don't think that's the point. If you want to donate for this, for the cause, I'm sure he's going to need more of the money in order to get good representation from lawyers, from aviation lawyers in this case, and hopefully he wins and gets this retracted. And this kind of sends a message to local governments that they can't really do anything that they want with drone pilots. I think they were trying to make an example of someone, which is just a terrible idea at this stage. So we'll see where this goes. Again, I'll keep you guys posted, and I hope that James kind of gets some justice out of this. Quick update on Pilot Institute. We have a new free course just released at the end of last week, The Ultimate Guide to Becoming a Drone Pilot. The reason I decided to record this course, and I made it free, it's pretty short. It's about an hour, hour and 15 minutes. And it basically goes over all of the information that we get asked all the time at Pilot Institute. And I did this because, not because we're tired of answering questions, we love doing that, we love educating people, but there's just a lot of questions from people about how you become a drone pilot, the difference between flying for fun, flying for commercial purposes, all the questions that we get. Is probably about 20 questions that I answer in there that I get every single day when we talk to potential customers. We talk about opportunities for drone pilots. This is a question that comes up a lot. What can you do? How much money can you make? And I promise I will not tell you that you can make millions or get paid hundreds of dollars every hour that you fly your drone, because that's not really the reality of things. I'm not saying you can't make money by flying your drone. By all means, you can. But I'm trying to be realistic with you. So this is a realistic approach. For those of you that have taken my courses before, you know I am realistic, and I'm kind of telling you the way that it is. I'm not trying to sugarcoat things. So there's also, at the end of it, I put a little guide together for the best commercial drones at the moment, based on what you do. I get that question all the time, which drone should I use? Well, my first question is, it depends. What are you going to do with the drone? So I kind of put this together, kind of giving you some options. So that's available. I'm going to put a link down here. It's all free. You just need to create a quick account, and then you get access to the videos. With that being said, 5,000 followers, we just reached that. Kind of really excited about this. We're growing every week. Get a lot of really good conversation with you guys in the comments. So as always, leave your comments down there. Love reading what you think, especially with what's going on right now with this James Benson thing. Tell me what you think, and kind of what you think is going to happen with this. And this is it. That's all I have. Excited because on Friday, when this gets released, we're going to Sedona with Don, and we're going to be shooting some FPV and some Inspire 2 footage in Sedona. For those of you that are not familiar with Sedona, look it up. Go in Google. We found one spot. It's really hard to fly in Sedona without being into a an area where there is either close to the airport or it's a pretty busy area, but we found the perfect spot. So I think we're going to get some awesome footage. So look for that footage coming out probably next week. And then in the meantime, see you guys, fly safe, and see you next week.